So good evening, everyone. Group one is presenting on blue ocean strategy. So my teammates are Aarti Naveen, Ashish Goyal, Abhilash Ekka, Abhinav Gyani, Abhilash Baksala, Afsana, Alam Prabhu, Ankush, Ashutosh sir, and Bhushan sir. So next slide, sir.
Fantastic.
So we are covering the topic from like what is the need of this strategy, how this arrives, valuation, four action framework, and cases related to blue ocean strategy. Next slide, sir.
Lovely.
So coming to the definition, like blue ocean strategy is referred to the market for a product where there is no competition or very less competition, or you entering a new market. So it was given by like Wee Chen Kim and Rene Mogben. So it is first example came when this strategy arrived was Nintendo. So this is the previous slide, sir. Previous. Yes, sir. Yes. So blue ocean exists where the potential of the profits are very much higher, as there is a very low competition. We can see the as opposite of a red ocean strategy. So you can go for next slide, sir.
As there is no competition or irrelevant competition.
Yes, sir. It's like minimum competition there.
Yeah.
So we have seen like we can put the example of Uber there. So Uber is the like grown faster than any other company ever by reinventing the market. So Uber created a blue ocean strategy. So they turned the non-customer into customers. So the demand created and then they fought over that and so make the business profitable and rapid. So this is like different between a blue ocean strategy and red ocean strategy. So in blue ocean strategy, this, the market space is created which is free and from any competition. And whereas red ocean strategy, it is competing in an existing market. So competition is irrelevant here and it has no effect on the success of a business. Otherwise, like prospects of profits or growth are reduced. So in blue ocean strategy, like create the uncontested market space, make the competition irrelevant, create and capture new market, break the value cost and align the whole system of a firm's activities with a strategic choice of differentiation and low cost. So there are some tools and like a strategy canvas, which will be further discussed by my teammates.
Sure. You can carry on. Good job. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. So let's discuss the need of blue ocean strategy. When we differentiate the strategies on the basis of differentiation and cost, so there are two types of strategies. One is end-to-end strategy and other are either-or strategy. So conventional strategies are either-or strategy. According to conventional strategies, the companies can either reduce the cost or provide a value product to the customer. Sir, previous slide, please. But blue ocean strategy is end-to-end strategy. According to it, the company can provide a high value product and also can reduce the cost through its value innovation. The second need is to create uncontested market space. Conventional strategies focus on creating a market barrier and limit to the competition in that territory only. But blue ocean strategy breaks the territories and enter the new market spaces. The third need is to provide a step-by-step process. Blue ocean strategy provides a step-by-step process that firstly see the market in which they are working now. They are working already. Then see is there any strategic space available to work upon, and then see how can the non-customers can be potential customers can be converted into customers. So this is a step-by-step approach which is used in blue ocean strategy. Next point is maximize the opportunity while minimizing the risk. Blue ocean strategy is risk minimizing and opportunity maximizing strategy. Yes. It basically blue ocean strategy helps the company to there is risk in every strategy, whether it is blue ocean or red ocean. But blue ocean strategy helps to mitigate the risk to a very lower level. There is one tool which is called Blue Ocean Idea Index. Through that, a company can check its idea whether it is viable or not. And the last need is to create a win-win outcome. Basically, there are three pillars: value, profit, and people, on which a strategy can work. Blue ocean strategy provides the value to the consumers, provides the profit to the company, and also engages the employees and stakeholders with the company. So it works on the three basis on which we can say that blue ocean strategy creates a win-win outcome for everyone.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. The topic I am going to discuss is like the value innovation, the core stone of blue ocean strategy. In this, the value innovation places equal emphasis on the value and the innovation thing. Here, the cost is reduced and the buyer value is increased. Like the cost savings are made by eliminating and reducing the factors an industry competes on. And the buyer value is lifted by raising and creating the element that industry has never offered. So value innovation is very necessary. And I would like to say something by quote that man cannot discover new oceans unless he has the courage to lose the sight of the show. So value innovation is very, very necessary. Thank you.
Wow. Courage to lose the sight of the show. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm doing four action framework in the blue ocean strategy. So there are four frameworks: eliminate, reduce, raise, and create. So first, what we can do is we can identify what factors the current players in the industry are competing on, like and what aspects they are competing on, and what they are focusing on, and what kind of values they are providing to their customers. So if there are certain factors, we can reduce or eliminate. So we have to analyze these factors. So which factor we have to eliminate or we have to reduce. So these factors will help us in reducing the input cost. So by decreasing the input cost, we can increase our profit. So there are other two factors are raise and create. So these factors can be created in order to lift the buyers value and create new demand in the market. Yes, sir. Next slide, please. And
till now, yes, we have discussed about what exactly is a blue ocean strategy and how it is helpful for the industry. Now we will see about how to actually formulate a blue ocean strategy so that we can compete in the market. So the six frame pathwork to formulate blue ocean strategy depends upon six factors: the industry, strategic groups, buyer group, orientation, service product, time. So first, coming on to industry, while creating a strategy, we don't have to just look in the particular industry but across the alternate industries also, because in the particular industry where your organization is, you will only found a substitute of your product. But if you look across the industries, then there can be a product which are alternative for your product and which can harm your market. So you always have to look for the alternative industries also while formulating the blue ocean strategy. We have also, once formulating, you should also look for the strategic groups. Strategic groups are those groups within an organization which pursue a different interest. Like we can take example of Tata. There are different groups in Tata, one which focus on the performance while the other focuses on the price of the product. Coming on to the next, that buyer are the main thing that the organization should focus on. And there are not a particular group of buyer, but a total chain of buyers who directly or indirectly involved in the buying decision, like the person who is buying the product and the actual person who is going to use that product can be different. And there can be an influencer who influence the decision of buying the product and the traders who intermediate buyers to buy that product. And there can be a regulators or decision makers that like a brand ambassador who influence you to buy that product. All those come under the buyer group. So coming on to the complementary product means, what can be the services that you can provide? Your company's work doesn't end when the customer has purchased that product or the used that service, but it also works on what will happen after he has purchased your product or after he has used your services. Like if you have purchased a phone, then what next? You have to provide his services to that phone. There should be a service center. If there are any problems, then one person should formulate strategy upon that thing also.
Thank you. Thank you.
Coming on to the next function is the emotional function and functional appeal. Emotional, a product should be targeted toward the emotional need of the consumer. A consumer should be emotionally attached to a product so that he can buy it. And functional appeal, the obviously if only if the consumer is attracted toward it by the emotional means and the product don't have any function, then it will not sell. So a product should have functional appeal also towards it.
Yes.
So also time factor is the most important factor. Whether you are the product you are giving to the industry is the latest trend or not. You can't just sell a product which was a trend in 1920s that doesn't even apply in the time limit of 2020. So one should focus on the time in which you have introducing the project or the product.
Thank you.
Over to
so moving on to some cases on the global basis.
How much time your team might be requiring furthermore?
I'll comprise it to 45 seconds only.
Oh my God. And after that, you're closing it. You did the last presenter. You were the last presenter?
Yes, sir. I am the last presenter. That is why I'm taking less time. Okay.
All the best. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, sir, and batchmates. So I am here to discuss the cases that are related to Blue Ocean strategy around the globe. First one was Apple. During 1990s, there was widespread illegal persecution of the musics around the globe. And because of that, Steve Jobs, what he did, he tapped that potential and went on to legalize that thing by providing the songs in their mobile only or in something which is quite handy. So he partnered with BMG, EMI Group, Sony, Universal Music Group and Warner Bros. Records to go on and give music at the doorsteps. Today, the name of that thing was iTunes, and it was launched in 2003. He somewhere turned the red ocean blue. Today, iTunes offers more than 37 million songs. This data is 3 months old. Right now, it has turned to 39 million songs, and per minute, 25 billion songs are 15,000 songs are being downloaded per minute. And that is the reach which Steve Jobs has created in the market. At the same time, he legalized that thing. Next one, please. So this was the quotation that Steve Jobs used while representing or initiating that iTunes. Focus does not mean saying yes, it means saying no. That means he objectively determined what is right and what is wrong. And he, on the basis of his instinct, went on to pursue something which is in better, which shall fall in better basket to the greater number of public. So this was the four key that he utilized. First one, observe, that he observed the market of illegalized music. Second one, introspect, the market prosperity. Third one was innovate, that innovation of iTunes. And fourth one was reach, and reach is 35 billion customers. Next one. Next one is the example of Ford Motors. In 1908, Ford Motors came up with the Model T car, and they were offering it for $850, which was the half of the existing price of the cars. And those cars which were available before Model T of Ford, they were very much expensive and they were not much reliable. Even though the Ford the car with which Ford came up with was only of one color, but it somewhere grasped the market with the market share of 61% in only a decade. Next one. So this is the car that replaced the horse carriages in USA and United Kingdom. So sir, I'll end the slides and thank you very much. Our group presentation is
Philips T. Kedley. I just quickly run through.
I'll run through this one also. This is the third example. In this, what Philips did in the 1990s, what was happening in United Kingdom was the main problem with tea and kettle industry was the lime scale. Whenever the public used to brew tea, then there was a formation of a circular lime scale on the in the kettle. So somewhere Philips saw that, even though that was the problem of water resources, that was the problem of water department, but Philips came came in front and tried to decimate this thing to null. So what they did, they used invented a kettle with a mouth filter that would effectively capture lime scale, and whenever the water was poured and whenever you will brew water, then no lime scale will come up. So this somewhere again Philips turned the red ocean blue. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Oh my God, that's fantastic and phenomenal. Blue ocean strategy. Thank you very much. That's beautifully presented. Yes, guerrilla marketing team too is ready, but let me clarify. Let me give a little addition to what the beautiful presenter. Ek baar team number one ke liye jordaar taaliyan dijiye, please. Let's appreciate them. My God, that's fantastic. See, blue ocean bahut sundar hai. और समुंदर बहुत बड़ा है. ओशन मतलब इट्स इमेंस, ह्यूज, मैसिव और बहुत सुंदर है. रेड ओशन. रेड क्यों बना? खून बहा. जब खून बहते हैं तो वो ब्लू ओशन बिकम्स रेड ओशन. खून खून क्यों बहा? वहां पे क्यों बहता है? एक दूसरे को मार रहे हैं, एक दूसरे को तलवार से काट रहे हैं. कॉम्पिटिटर्स, people are competing in that space, in that space ek dusre ko compete kar rahe hain, ek dusre, they are looking at each other like a competitor, how I take that chair from you, this chair from you, they are fighting with each other and there is a bloodshed. That's why the ocean has become red. But now I don't want to fight, I don't want to have any competition. The ocean is bahut bada hai, it's immense, and let me innovate my product, let me get into something where, you know, the market is so big, the world is so big, and there's so much, you know, you go into the world where there is no competition, there is no direct competition. I don't fight with you, you don't fight with me, and I create my own market space and I enjoy my blue ocean. You know, the market is massive. So that's what, you know, blue ocean strategy is, having no competition, creating into a space or everyone can play, you play and you enjoy that market. Market is so big, you know, they can still do that. That's what these people created. Thank you very much for team number one. Now team number two is ready. Let's get going. Looks like now 5-8. Maybe, I don't know. I think I want to leave you guys today, maybe at 5:15. So maybe, you know, we'll have these two teams presenting today and we'll close it at 5:15. Maybe tomorrow the first thing we do is have 5 minutes each for the rest of the teams, or if you want to continue, I'm okay with that. I would leave it to you. Okay, what do we do? Should we close it at 5:15 and have the rest of the teams presenting tomorrow first thing?
Yes sir, we have it so at that time.
So we'll let this team take 5 minutes or maximum 7. It's already 5:08, 5-6 minutes or 7 minutes. 5:15 we are closing, and tomorrow we will tomorrow we have again 3 hours time. Not tomorrow, day after tomorrow, right? Monday we'll have we'll spend some time on that. And all the best, team 2, go ahead.
Good evening, sir and batchmates. Today we are going to discuss guerrilla marketing. Our group 2 members include Dr. Dadania Ash, Madhu Dasari, Pawaz Ahmed Sheikh, Ganga Vasu, Harman Kaur Chawla, Hemant Santosh Dandalaya, Jamadar Azharuddin Ansar Ali, Janani Balasubramanyam, K. Surya Teja, Pujita Poshika, and Kovuri Sneet Reddy.
I'm so happy seeing that slide and seeing you reading out those names. That's very important. That's the team spirit. All the best. Go ahead.
Coming to guerrilla marketing, guerrilla marketing is the art and science of breaking conventional marketing rules, bypassing the traditional outlets, and using uncommon sense to reach people with marketing messages. Coming to the guerrilla history of guerrilla marketing, the term guerrilla comes from guerrilla warfare, yeah, in which soldiers use quick, unexpected attacks followed by fast retreats rather than fighting for prolonged periods out in the open.
Yes.
Like guerrilla warfare, guerrilla marketing messages appear seemingly out of nowhere, making a big impression on onlookers before quickly disappearing. And the term guerrilla was first coined by J. Conrad Levinson in 1984 in his book Guerrilla Marketing. And the idea of guerrilla marketing is to generate a buzz and ideally to turn viral. And it is a cost effective alternate to large advertising campaigns. Next slide, please.
Yes. LTTE and used to fight the war. LTTE, you know, in Sri Lanka, those days, they used to call them guerrilla warfare. It's like quick attacks, quickly retreat and get back, hide and seek, you know, game like that. All the best. Go ahead.
Sir, coming to guerrilla versus viral, there is a slight misconception that is there is a difference between guerrilla and viral marketing, but actually both of these marketing types goes hand in hand. When coming to viral marketing, it indicates digital word of mouth marketing. Like viral marketing get its name from the way in which physical viruses spread, like corona, like which each individual unit replicating ceaselessly, creating exponential growth. A viral marketing campaign relies on social media sharing and other online word of mouth tactics to reach large number of people through their friends and contacts.
Yeah.
And here I want to mention one example, difference between the guerrilla and viral. In 2008, for promoting the Hollywood film, The Dark Knight, and coming to guerrilla marketing, they used mobile billboard trucks. On the mobile billboard trucks, they displayed this poster of Dark Knight, and these trucks display this poster virtually anywhere, quickly moving on to cover different cities in the state. So that advertising right in front of the people, like moving on the roads, etc. And coming to viral marketing, the production company of The Dark Knight, that is Warner Bros., created a fake political campaign website for Harvey Dent. Harvey Dent is a character in the movie. They created a fake political campaign website, providing the fans with shareable campaign posters and other tools to spread the hype. It is a viral marketing. Like both of the marketing goes hand in hand. Like the result, the intended result of guerrilla marketing is for it to go viral. That is, there is a slight difference between them, but both of them goes hand in hand.
Yes.
Lovely. Next slide, please. Yeah.
WhatsApp. WhatsApp, the way WhatsApp spread from in the market is also through viral, like 1 to 10, 10 to 100, 100 to 1,000. Go ahead. Suretheja. Any of your team members?
Good morning, everyone. I'm Fawaz Ahmed Sheikh.
Yes.
So here we can see that, as Surya has already said, that it is the whole thought-provoking concept to generate a viral buzz and to turn it into viral thing. That is the aim of guerrilla marketing. The objective of guerrilla marketing is to eventually turn it viral, to make it spread among people.
Wow.
But this is done through many types. And here you can see the different types: ambush marketing, astroturfing, buzz marketing, guerrilla projection, grassroots marketing, stealth marketing, street marketing, and wild posting, which you're going to see in the next slides.
Lovely.
So the first thing we have here is stealth marketing. This is also known as buzz marketing. And this is a marketing strategy where the people, we are marketing to them, but they have no idea that they are being marketed to.
Wow.
And it is done in two ways that is very well known. First thing is placement, product placement. You're going to see an ad or a movie. You will suddenly see Coca-Cola, you see some other phone company which is being explicitly shown in that movie. There's no other brand. So that is a stealth marketing towards you. And then there's undercover marketing, which is also a more devious kind of marketing, but that is still under debate. As you can see over here, this is stealth marketing. There the zebra lining has been replaced by McDonald's French fries. And so people, when they're looking at that, they will remember it and they might get hungry and they might go to eat. So as you can see, this is not done to generate immediate sales. There's no actual profit for the company. But this will create interest in people. They'll start talking with each other. In the next slide, we can see an example also. So this is an example of Sony Ericsson, which marketed their mobile T681 using fake tourists. They paid actors to act like tourists, to go to people and tell them, take my photo, please, and give them the phone. And so when the people took the photo of these tourists, the tourists will tell them specific lines that Sony told them to tell the people.
Oh my God.
This way, the people are somewhat interested in the phone, and they might even buy the phone. But actually, this got lots of negative reception towards the company. But you might think, why the company followed it? In fact, their marketing costs were only $4 million, which is actually very less compared to a billboard or something else like that. Another example would be of some cigarette companies in which they pay people to smoke the cigarette publicly and just offer it to people who are walking by. And if the people like it, they will ask the name of the brand. And you know, they might turn people into customers. So this was stealth marketing. Next will be taken by my batchmates.
Thank you, Fawaz. Good afternoon, sir, and batchmates.
Yes.
Sir, actually, it's time for our quiz.
Yeah, okay. It's okay. We're closing now. 1 minute. Pujita, just 1 minute close. Otherwise, your team can continue also tomorrow, 5:15, no? Is that okay with you, Pujita?
Yes, sir. Shall I continue or shall I stop, sir?
I think there's a quiz about to start at 5:15. So you people have to go there.
Fine, sir. Fine, sir. We'll continue it tomorrow.
We'll continue tomorrow. Take care, guys. All the best. Have a nice evening. Tomorrow. You are awesome. Keep rocking. All the best to you in the quizzes today. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Monday. See you on Monday. 2 to 5.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
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 Bye. Take care. God bless.
Thank you, sir.